In 2017, UNICEF and the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation embarked on a journey to strengthen social and behavior change in UNICEF's programming around the world. But wait, what exactly is social and behavior change? In short, SBC. SBC is about understanding the factors that influence people's actions and using that knowledge to drive positive change in society. What does that really mean? For example, during the COVID-19 pandemic, SBC approaches were key to increasing vaccination coverage by helping to better understand the reasons why people decide to get vaccinated or not. This meant, for instance, tackling fears and rumors about vaccines and adapt the way vaccinations were offered based on community voices and feedback. In recent years, UNICEF has increasingly integrated SBC approaches into its work to support children and communities around the globe. So what was evaluated? In 2023, the UNICEF Evaluation Office assessed what the investments in SBC had achieved and whether UNICEF had improved its capacity and overall use of social and behavior change. An evaluation team was formed to collect and analyze a wide range of data to provide a comprehensive picture of how UNICEF's SBC efforts were shaping up. They reviewed documents and examined data sets such as SBC quality indicators or resources. They talked to 75 people either engaged or experts in SBC, both within and outside UNICEF. They sent out surveys to UNICEF staff and partners, receiving over 600 responses. And they conducted 8 case studies to study changes in more detail in Guatemala, Niger, Egypt, Somalia, Iraq, Armenia, India, and the Pacific Islands. And here are the 3 key findings of the evaluation. First, UNICEF's SBC capacity has improved significantly. However, there are discrepancies across regions, countries, and technical areas, meaning that SBC is strongly integrated in some places, but much less in others. Second, UNICEF's improved SBC capacity has led to better SBC programming. Many different initiatives have advanced the quality of SBC approaches, such as the development of rapid data collection platforms and tools for social listening to gain insights into the beliefs, attitudes, and behaviors of the people that UNICEF wants to support. Third, the development and uptake of SBC-related global public resources improved, which contribute to a better understanding of SBC, such as the publicly available SBC program guidance. But despite significant progress, SBC still faces challenges. Mainly, it needs to be more widely understood, funded, and integrated across the organization. Based on its findings and conclusions, the evaluation made 8 recommendations outlining concrete actions that UNICEF should take to further strengthen SBC. In summary, these are: strengthen SBC funding to be more long-term, impact-oriented, and well-distributed. Strengthen SBC leadership support and representation in decision-making processes. Reinforce evidence-based programming informed by SBC. And promote SBC in working with partners such as governments and the private sector. UNICEF is already acting on these recommendations to become better equipped in all areas of its work and to achieve positive impact for children and communities through social and behavior change. For more information about this evaluation, including the full report, you can either scan this QR code or directly visit www.unicef.org/evaluation/reports.